हेलो डियर चिल्ड्रेन, दिस इज आलोक सर एंड इन दिस पार्ट ऑफ द वीडियो आई विल एक्सप्लेन वेलोसिटी टाइम ग्राफ। होप यू ऑल आर फाइन एंड डूइंग योर स्टडी ऑनेस्टली। इन प्रीवियस पार्ट ऑफ द वीडियो आई हैव एक्सप्लेन ग्राफ्स एंड डिस्टेंस टाइम ग्राफ एंड द डिफरेंट टाइप्स ऑफ डिस्टेंस टाइम ग्राफ। नाउ इन दिस पार्ट ऑफ द वीडियो आई हैव ब्रॉट वेलोसिटी टाइम ग्राफ फॉर यू। सी द ग्राफ फर्स्ट। द वेलोसिटी टाइम ग्राफ, टाइम इज टेकन अलोंग एक्स एक्सिस एंड वेलोसिटी इज टेकन अलोंग वाई एक्सिस। दिस इज द ओरिजिन एंड वेलोसिटी टाइम ग्राफ शोज द वेरिएशन ऑफ वेलोसिटी ऑफ एन ऑब्जेक्ट विथ टाइम। हाउ वेलोसिटी वेरीज विथ टाइम, दिस प्लॉट इज शोन बाय वेलोसिटी टाइम ग्राफ। So, see the explanation. Velocity time graph is denoted by VT graph. It shows the variation of velocity of an object with time. To plot velocity time graph, we take the velocity along y-axis and time along x-axis, as I have already told you. Now, velocity time graph for uniform or motion or constant velocity. When an object has uniform motion, means it's traveling with constant velocity, the graph will be parallel to the time axis. That is, if an object have velocity, it's some non-zero velocity, that is my latest velocity becomes v1, and it is moving with velocity v1 constantly, that is at time t1 velocity is v1, at time t2 the velocity is also v1, means that time is changing, time is increasing, but velocity is not increasing. This is the case of uniform velocity, means the object is moving with constant velocity. Means when the object is moving constant velocity, when the object is moving with constant velocity, the velocity time graph will be parallel to time axis, like that, as you are seeing in the picture. See the explanation. For a linear uniform motion of an object, the velocity of the object does not change with time. So the velocity time graph is a straight line parallel to time axis as shown in figure. Velocity time graph is a straight line parallel to time axis when the object is moving with uniform velocity or constant velocity. Or this is also called the object moving with constant velocity since velocity is not changing with time. Since velocity is not changing with time, as you are seeing in the graph, this is also called graph of constant velocity. Now the important thing is that determination of speed, determination of distance covered. How we will calculate distance covered by the object using the graph. In a velocity time graph, the distance covered or magnitude of displacement given by the area enclosed by velocity time graph and with time axis means, if you have to calculate the distance covered by the object, we have to calculate the area of the velocity time graph. Means the area under velocity time graphs gives the distance covered by the object. Let us see in this graph. We know velocity equals to distance by time. This is the basic formula. So distance will be velocity multiplied by time, and this is the velocity axis, so SP will be the velocity, total SP will be the velocity and SR will be time taken. So multiplying velocity with time, we will get the area, we will get the distance covered, we will get the area and henceforth distance covered by the object. So let us let position P and Q on the graph correspond to time T1 and T2 respectively. Means when the object is at position P, at time T1 object is position P, at time T2 object is as position Q. Draw normals from P, PS on time axis and QR on time axis. So we have drawn the normals from point P and Q on the time axis. The distance moved by object is time T2 minus T1. This is T2, this is T1. Total time will be T2 minus T1. T2 minus T1 equals to SR. And the velocity is PS. So total distance equals to S equals to PS multiplied by SR, that is speed multiplied by time, distance equals to velocity into time, and velocity is PS and time is SR. Velocity is PS and time is SR. So velocity multiplied by time, that is distance covered, this will be given area of rectangle PQRS. If you are seeing that, this is the figure, that is PQRS represents rectangle, PQRS is representing a rectangle. So area of this rectangle gives the distance covered by the object, that is B multiplied by T2 minus T1. So we have determined that when we need to calculate the distance covered by the moving object, we have to calculate the area of the distance time graph. So two important points are there. When the object is moving with constant velocity or uniform velocity, the distance velocity time graph will be parallel to time axis. And second important point is that if you want to determine the distance covered by the moving object, you must have to calculate the area of velocity time graph. Now see how non-uniform motion represented in velocity time graph. Next, velocity time graph for uniformly accelerated motion. We have seen that how distance is calculated from velocity time graph. Now in this section, we will see that how uniformly accelerated motion is represented in velocity time graph. I have drawn a graph, let us see. This is x-axis, that is time axis, this is y-axis, velocity axis. An object is moving with uniform velocity, that initially the object is at P and after certain time it is at Q. So the velocity time graph for an accelerated motion of an object initially at rest is an inclined line passing through origin. So this is the case of uniformly accelerated motion, means velocity is continuously increasing with time. So this is this inclined line represents the motion of an object which is uniformly accelerated, that is B is directly proportional to T. Now calculation of uniform acceleration, how acceleration is calculated from velocity time graph. Consider two points P and Q. One velocity time graph corresponding to time T, corresponding to time T1 and T2, and velocity V1 and V2 respectively. Means this is point P at time T1, this is point Q at time T2. This is velocity V1 and this is velocity V2. Now how we will calculate the acceleration from the given graph? See some important points. Slope of the velocity time graph gives acceleration. Already I have told you what is slope. Slope is the angle of the graph of the straight line that the straight line makes with time axis. And slope of velocity time graph give acceleration. And slope is defined as the steepness of a line or the inclination of a line. This steepness or this inclination is called slope of the graph. And in this graph, slope is PQ. This PQ is the slope, and this is represented by, this is the ratio of QR by PR. So PQ equals to QR by PR. Now draw normals PS QR on point P and Q on time axis using triangle PQR. Now draw normal, that is QS on time axis, PT on time axis. Using triangle PQR, how we calculate acceleration? Acceleration is equals to rate of change of velocity. So change in velocity, that is QR, V2, V1. So QR will be change in velocity, that is V2 minus V1. PR, that is equals to TS, means T2 minus T1. R or S, this is T2 and this is T1. So PR or ST, both will be same, and this is equals to T2 minus T1. So change in velocity equals to V2 minus V1, and change in time equals to T2 minus T1. So acceleration is equals to change in velocity by change in time. Already you know from the definition of acceleration. So change in velocity, that is V2 minus V1, and change in time, that is T2 minus T1. Means QR by PR, which is same as the slope of the graph. Means slope of the graph gives acceleration. Slope of the VT graph gives acceleration of moving object. So the ratio PQR by PR is called slope of the graph, and slope of the velocity time graph acceleration. This is very important line. You must remember that. Now, velocity time graph for non-uniform motion. So, in this section, calculation of distance covered or magnitude of displacement. How distance is calculated by velocity time graph? This is the velocity time graph. An object is initially at P. After certain time, it reaches at Q. So, position P at time T1 and at position Q at time T2. Velocity of position when the object is position P, that is V1, and velocity of the object when it is position at Q, V2. So how we will calculate the distance covered by the object? Let us see the explanation. Consider two points P and Q on the plot corresponding to time T1 and T2. P point represents T1 and Q at T2. The object is at P at time T1 and the object reaches at Q at time T2. And velocity v1 and v2 respectively means the object is moving with velocity v1 when time is t1, and when time is t2 its velocity changes to v2. Now distance covered or the magnitude of displacement of a period of time given by the area under the velocity time graph of the object, the distance covered by the object in time t2 minus t1 is, means when we have to calculate the distance traveled by the moving object, we have to calculate the area of a velocity time graph. We have to calculate the area under velocity time graph. So this is how we will calculate area of a moving object which is in uniform acceleration. So area distance equals to area of the shaded region PQ, PQRST. Distance covered by or the magnitude of displacement equal to area of the shaded region, that is PQRST. So area of trapezium PQRST, or we can say that area of triangle plus area of rectangle, area of rectangle plus area of triangle. Either this is the area of trapezium or this is the sum of area of rectangle plus area of triangle. So if we calculate the area of this region, this shaded region, this area, this part under velocity time graph, so this will give distance covered by the object. Again, I am repeating it, for calculating distance by the moving object which is moving with uniform acceleration, we have to calculate the area of this velocity time graph for the calculation of distance. So this is equal to length into breadth, that is PT into TS, PT into TS, length into breadth, area of rectangle, plus half into B into H, that is half into B into H, that is half into base into height, area of triangle. So calculating this area, we can find the distance traveled by the moving object. So this is how we will calculate distance covered by the object or magnitude of displacement, by calculating the area of the shaded region or of the area of velocity time graph. Now, velocity time graph for non-uniformly accelerated motion. You know that when the acceleration is non-uniform, it will not be a straight line. That is, velocity changes at every interval, means sometime line increases, line sometime of the slope, all time slope will be changed. Slope will be changed every interval of time, means when the object is moving non-uniform acceleration, its graph will be non-linear or a zigzag line. Let an object moves along a straight line with non-uniform acceleration, the velocity of the object rise or fall, sometime rises, sometime falls. So without any uniformly time, this velocity time graph for such non-uniform acceleration motion is non-linear, that is zigzag line. So velocity time graph of a non-uniform motion, that is velocity time graph of an object which is moving with non-uniform acceleration, is a non-linear. In this case, sometime velocity increases, sometime decreases, means sometime rises, sometime falls with a non-uniformly time interval, means that the velocity time graph an object which is moving with non-uniform acceleration will be a zigzag line or non-linear line. So this is the end of the video. Now revise these two parts, that is distance time graph and velocity time graph, properly. More question will be there in your exams from this part. So stay tuned. and study honestly.